Hey guys, Thomas here. For this week's video, I've been really busy lately, so I'm gonna be doing a commentary over Passion Never Stops. I'm s a few things I want to say. I apologize that this video is late. I had some personal issues to take care of, and as a result, I wouldn't was not be able to record this until 9 o'clock at night. So it will probably be up a day late, but still, so I'm trying to think of what else. Think that's it. So Passion Never Stops. It's a very personal film. That I will also explain as we get into this. This is unscripted, so it's very I wanted to do a short film after nothing personal was gonna get done. Didn't was not gonna be able to get done at the time I wanted it to. But I so you know I thought well, kind of thought what Film Riot did, and that we could sit around and mope, or we could make a movie. So I thought to take the story of what happened after I found out Nothing Personal had to be postponed and make that into a movie. It's not entirely accurate, but I'll get into that as soon as when I get to this part. Okay, so without any further ado, let's get started. I gotta turn on the audio. This is the first time I've actually got to use my logo in an actual film. It's 'cause seriously, it's just burning space in my hard drive, so excuse me. Yeah, I'm working on a shorter logo to put in all of my videos and a watermark, so Thunderbolt Films presents. Yeah, I also put that there too. In association with Long Media Films. It's funny, that's Ryan's production company. I really like this shot. It's funny, Ryan, I told him that I was gonna do this, and, I said, "Hey, will you help me do this?" That right there, the review must go on. In the original script, I actually had a point in the film. If you guys are aware, know of the Nostalgia Critic, like I am, you'll know that that's a film of his, and it's kind of what inspired Passion Never Stops. In fact, the original title of this was "The Show Must Go On," and then I thought, oh, that's kind of ripping it off, and then the second title was pa Endless Passion, but then I just kind of reverted it to Passion Never Stops to the message it gets to. This in my old room before I rearranged everything. This is actually this is kind of like a Back to the Future type of intro where it's like a Steadicam showing the room of who the character is. So, and I used my DIY glide cam for those who remember both tutorials. That audio that you hear me talking over the Steadicam shots is actually a production vlog I never released. So, because literally I made that vlog the day I, like, just minutes, even like a half hour before I knew it was going to be postponed. So, yeah, it's symbolic. The name Rob is not the real name. But the situation is real, because like the original guy, I don't want to name his name. I'm not bashing him or anything, 'cause he had a totally legit reason not to be able to do it. But he had a job and over the summer, and we just couldn't get it done in time, and it kind of crushed me. And that's one thing I want to talk about. This real situation, Meek, I was actually texting the guy instead of calling him, talking to him on the phone, because I'm not really one who calls people. I don't know why. It's just, I mean, I don't know why. I just don't. I'm a shy guy, so. But, and also me talking on the phone with Ryan, that didn't happen. We were actually talking on Facebook when it actually happened in real life, and there's other stuff that I didn't put in here because I didn't really feel it was necessary. Well, it kind of was, but this is like based on that story. This is something Ryan doesn't know either. When we were talking, I was actually after Ryan and I had a little talked for a little while, I was actually crying after we talked. So it's very because it's very it's hard to explain, but yeah, I can't. Oh yeah, there's actually three. How many is there? Like six Ryan Longs on my phone. There's Ryan in his office. One of them's a Skype Yahoo. That keyboard's actually his brother's, so he got it at Goodwill, I think. Yeah, Long Media Films, nice little plug. And cracked iPhone screen. yeah. funny thing about this scene, when we got at Ryan when I got at Ryan's house to shoot the scene, I actually forgot that it was a night times. It took place at night, so I don't know if you can tell, but we actually and you know he has a window in there, and it was daylight in the middle of July, I think. And so we had to put a black thermal or a fleece blanket over the window, and it worked good. That's the only day for night I like doing. I don't like doing digital day for night. I think it looks terrible. Yeah, this. I actually did do this. This is something, because, like, in the film, it's not entirely accurate. And it's not really supposed to be. I didn't want it. I didn't write it like that. And I really loved the music here. I was actually just I did this for like an hour. I'm not I in real life, I didn't shoot it for an hour. I didn't want to put that there. That'd just be boring. So, I really like using like well, I'll get to that. Just using facial expressions to accentuate how the character is feeling. So, I actually do sleep with that many blankets on all year round. So I'm not kidding. Yeah, this dream scene, I thought it was important to establish why he was feeling like this. And I actually these messages aren't real. They're photoshopped, but I have gotten these messages before when I was younger, like I don't know, 13, 12, 13 or something. Yeah, it's there's a spelling mistake in there. That was done on purpose. It actually was that early when I shot that. It was, oh God. It actually was that tired. I actually shot this before, but I was wearing a different sleepwear. But so I thought, okay, the sleepwear, the sleeveless shirt, I looked better in. So thought that'd be good. Yeah, there's like just ambience. I really like using just silence and facial expression just to express what the character's feeling. So, yeah, gets up. There were some audio issues I couldn't fix, so and also like this stuff, like me getting in the car and just driving and thinking about that didn't happen. I don't usually get up that often. So yeah, this Ryan was in the front seat filming me driving. We were actually on our way to lunch. So like all the stuff I shot at my house, that I just shot that myself, and all the stuff that didn't take place at my house, Ryan was there with me. So this is at I believe it's Providence Park in downtown Franklin. It's a beautiful place. I used to go here a lot when I was a kid. So Ryan shot this. This is the on the glide cam. It really looks great. We were really just kind of going all around this place. This is a big park, and we were just kind of going all around to see what shots we could get. Oh my God, there's so much audio issues. I'm not even kidding. Like, half the time the audio was unusable, and I had to go back and audition and fix it. Like, oh God. The old Bolts Tutorials theme intro. So this scene was actually with Ryan. It was actually a added scene we had to come up with, because originally it was just going to be on the phone, but we had to actually no originally it was going to be a text, so but we couldn't see the phone in time, so and so we just decided to film it in his car. Ironically though, he can't drive, so this is Benjamin's. We thought this would be a great idea to film here because they're really cool people. We filmed here before, shooting a promotional video for a client, or yeah, a client for one of our friends. So yeah, this scene, this is pretty much what the conversation on Facebook we were taught was. Just, I wasn't crying. I'm not crying in this scene, so. Some people, I've heard a couple people, one person say that Ryan didn't really give that good of a performance, and, you know, I mean, I didn't cast him for his performance. I cast him because he's my friend, and this is an accurate depiction of that. Oh, that scene, that little pause right there, when you were thinking about, you know what? I really like that stuff. I really like just pauses to accentuate what someone means, what it means. So, anyway, what was I saying? Oh, well. This was the conversation we had, and I casted Ryan because, you know, I think this is an important scene to accent. To ex go into detail of, you know, these two characters' friendship, and it's really a depiction, pretty accurate depiction of the friendship Ryan and I have. So, without him, I don't know what I would have done with when Nothing Personal got postponed. It's hard to talk about. This is a matte shot, day for night shot. It's actually it is a digital day for night shot, but it's I don't mind those, but just done right. I'll exp I might explain more about that a little later, but in another video. Yeah, this ending, I think this ending is like I was kind of inspired by The Outsiders, you know, the S.E. Hinton novel, by this kind of like going, bringing it back full circle, a circ like it's a circular script. So, and I just thought that's so clever, in the book, in the movie. These funny thing, these shots were shot with my Galaxy S3, my smartphone, and they were just kind of stabilized in After Effects, and they work good. Like, this film did not cost anything to make. Well, I mean, we spent like $40, $20 each just to get something to eat. So, yeah, I'm really proud of what this film, how this film turned out, and you know, yeah, really proud of the story. And even though I was not able to get nothing personal done by the time I turned 18, which is by the time you're watching this, 5 days from now, so no, 6 days from now, no, five, sorry. I was able to get this done, and I was able to get pretty a lot of other things done too before I turned 18, so I am very proud of that. So, and yeah, the video's over. So, yeah, that's all yeah, I forgot about that. A lot of films do that. They put a shorter outro. So, yeah, that's really it, guys. So, I'll do more commentaries like when it gets closer to like finals, or if I'm in the middle of shoot, we'll be shooting Dark Force pretty soon. So I'll might be doing a commentary on that, something else, and like when it gets towards closer to finals, I'll probably do commentaries then, because I want to get videos out every week for you guys. So, but until then, you can follow me on Twitter at ThomasBolt1, like the Facebook page Thunderbolt Films, follow me on Instagram the Tom Bold, and subscribe to the Thunderbolt Vlogs channel, as well as this channel, Thomas Bolt, if you're not already. So that's it. You take it easy.